Today I'm going to show you a set of three tips that I call strategic plagiarism. First tip is when you are starting a new application and you choose create, don't start from blank. Instead, I would try, if possible, to find a template that is as close as possible to the application you have in mind. So let's say, for example, the leave request application that exists here in these template galleries seems to be a good, somewhat of a fit to what you are trying to do. So what you can do is you can rename it, choose the form factor you want, and go ahead and create. And what's going to happen is that template will be used to create an instance for you in your environment with all the screens, controls, navigation, etc., etc. So at this point, this instance of the application, you've got an amazing head start on getting your application to meet your needs. Now, of course, it's never going to be the case that what's in this is going to be exactly what you need, but what I would recommend is go through it and really understand the application, follow the logic, run it, experiment, and really understand it. And this will give you a great leg up in not only creating the app, but understand the overall architecture of the app. So that's strategic plagiarism number one. Plagiarism number two is, in a way, plagiarizing from yourself. Let's say you've done that. You've created a beautiful My Leave request, but now you need to make a new version of it, or perhaps not a new version, but a completely separate version that you want to share with somebody else, or maybe build for another customer. So in this case, save as, just give your application a new name, and once again, what you're doing is you're creating a copy, but in this case, you're creating a copy based on your own work. So in a way, you're plagiarizing from yourself. And once you have that, then you've got this great app to work with. You can evolve it separately from the initial version, or you can use it as a place to experiment, break things, try out new ideas without breaking the initial version. And finally, another great way of safely experimenting is to go ahead and plagiarize within your own application by using the duplicate screen function. So once you go ahead and do that, you'll get a copy of that screen. All the controls are renamed, so there's no name collisions. And you can then play around with this new login screen functionality and either use it and ultimately replace the initial login screen or migrate some of the logic and changes to the initial one. So those are three ways of, I call, strategic plagiarizing that can really help your productivity within the Power Apps environment. Thanks.